Hey everybody, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be talking about confidence and how that ties into Counter-Strike. Also, why confidence in Counter-Strike sometimes isn't a good thing, alright? We'll jump in game here soon, but I just wanted to go over a couple things first. So, confidence in the real world, alright? Usually, having confidence is good. All right. When it comes to doing your job, when it comes to public speaking, when it comes to being in a friend group, having confidence is good. So, for example, doing your job, you're probably going to do your job more efficiently and effectively with confidence than you would without confidence, because you're not going to be hesitant to do things. You know exactly where to do things. You know exactly where to put things, how to do them, when to do them, what something means. You're confident. Right? When it comes to public speaking, you've done it before, you're comfortable with the crowd, you know your jokes are going to land, you know what you say will get applause, you're confident in it compared to somebody who's never done it before. They're not confident in it. Or even your own friend group, right? You are friends with all these people for years and years and years. You know what kind of humor they like. You know touchy subjects. You know what to say. You know what not to say. You know when someone's upset. You're confident in your ability not only to read the group, but to interact with the group effectively. So now tying all that into Counter-Strike. In Counter-Strike, having confidence is somewhat like real-world confidence. You know, it's good in some places, but also it can be bad if you have too much confidence. So let's go over why confidence is good. It shouldn't take too long. It's pretty obvious, all right? You've been playing a lot recently. This is your third match of the day. You won your first two. Everything you were doing was pretty much working. All the normal things you were doing worked. Things you do just about every match, all your patterns, they weren't really countering you too much. So you're going to go into the next map feeling pretty confident, all right? Everything you've done's worked. No need to change it. I know what I can do. I know what I can't do. That's it. Okay? Good. Now, let's say that it's your first match of the day, all right, and you're playing on a map train. Let's say it's round four. You started out T-side. You guys are winning 4-0, all right, and you hold down tab. You look at the scoreboard, and you have 12 kills and 2 deaths, all right? So you've done pretty well so far. You have a 6 KD ratio. You probably have like 150 ADR. You're feeling pretty hot, and every round that you guys have won, you've ran out A. Alright, you just flashed out, you sprinted out, that's it. Alright, your teammates got some kills, you also picked up some kills here and there, but you're feeling really confident, maybe overconfident. One guy on your team calls, hey, maybe since we've gone A fast every round, let's do like a slow B. Alright, let's completely counter them, let's see if they're gonna, maybe they stack towards A, maybe the B player cheats over, maybe we can get a free site because they're trying to counter that, let's counter their counter. Alright, and so everybody's like on board, everybody goes, yeah, let's do that. And you go, nah, bro, I'm better than these kids fucking suck, I'm just gonna run out there and one tap them, let's go. So you're gonna flash out, you say, hey, flash for me guys, flash for me. Alright, you run out, they're flashing, and then you go to get this kill, and they're opping, or you just get completely annihilated, and you die. And you've lost the round, okay? Now, the reason why you got those kills in the first place, it's not, nothing really changed, you're still playing against the same enemies, the same opponents, so why were you able to get all those kills in the first place, but then when you tried to do it again for like the fifth time, it just didn't work, right? Well, one, the people that you're playing against are the same skill level as you, or at least damn near it, alright? So they're going to counter it, just like you. If you were having an off day, and somebody swang out here 4 times in a row and killed you, you know, there's a good chance you get the kill the fifth time. You can expect it, you can play a different angle, you're gonna counter what they're doing, alright? Not only that, but the times that you did kill them, alright, maybe they didn't have the best gun, maybe they didn't have armor, maybe they didn't have utility, maybe one of their teammates whiffed a shot, maybe something happened, alright? Just something happened. Not every time you win a round, it's because you did everything right. Majority of the time, I'd argue, you win a round because the enemies did something wrong, not because you did something right. Okay, you can still do right things, like correct things, but it's more likely that the enemies fucked something up and you took advantage of that. Now, taking advantage of that technically can be considered doing the right thing, but it's all started. The dominoes fell when the enemies did the wrong thing. Okay, so your confidence for being like, yeah, I have better aim than them, I can run out there and kill them, is kind of fake, and it's going to lead you to do things that aren't going to work over and over and over again. All right, that confidence of, no, I'm better than them, I can run out their heads on them, they won't see what's coming. All right, that's not good. You need to know when to rein in your confidence. Now, on the flip side of that, not having confidence in Counter-Strike, one could argue, is even worse. Okay. The problem with not having confidence, and I'll do a little anecdotal evidence here, all right? The past, not this week, but the week prior, I wasn't feeling too confident in my skills. So I said, you know what? I'm just going to deathmatch for this whole week, all right? Just really grind it out. I'm still going to play some matches here and there, maybe retakes, maybe aimbots, but for the most part, I'm going to put on a podcast and I'm going to deathmatch for an hour, hour and a half. All right, so I did that. And after about 5 days, I was like, you know what? Let's play some Mythic Ruby. I think I'm ready to play against people that are at a high level. And I went into the Ruby match and I played horribly. All right. And we lost games and we lost games and we lost games. And it got to a point where I had lost so many games that I was lower on the leaderboard for the month than I would have been if I hadn't played any matches. I had gone negative. Okay. And at that point, I looked at it and I was like, I've been practicing my aim. I feel like my aim is better than it's been in a while, all right, because I haven't grinded out deathmatch in a long time, but I feel like my aim's better than it has been in a while. Why am I playing so poorly? Why am I not winning, right? And I thought about it, and it's because I'm so worried about making a mistake, I'm not confident in my gameplay, that I'm doing things that I'm not comfortable with. For example, if I do something in a regular Facet Pug, ESEA Pug, League even, or matchmaking, all right, I do the same kind of play just about every time I play the map. All right, so on Mirage, let's say I lurk underpass. I've lurked underpass thousands of times over the course of my career. All right, what I'm not super comfortable with is lurking out the apps. All right, I've done it a lot of times, but I've done a lot of other things a lot more, all right? I've probably done that the least amount of times, although I've done it a lot. So in a match, like in Ruby, if I go to lurk underpass and I tell myself, oh no, that's probably not the best play because I'm all alone, I could get caught off guard, somebody could kill me and then we're down a man because I made the mistake of making that decision, I'm gonna do something that I'm less comfortable with, like lurking B. And because I'm taking myself out of my best spot, obviously, it's going to have an impact on my gameplay. Now, in simple terms, something that everybody can get behind is, you know, it's the same thing as, hey, I've done one thing 100 times. I've done the other thing 5 times. Guess which one I'm better at doing? Obviously, it's the one that you've done 100 times. You've seen more. You're able to identify patterns more easily. You can see what's coming. You can predict. You've seen just about everything that they can throw at you compared to the one you've done 5 times. Okay. Now, it's a pretty, like, simple concept. All right. It's, you know, but sometimes... It's a pretty simple concept, but sometimes when it comes to Counter-Strike, simple concepts need to be spelled out. Unlike in the real world, where obviously something you've done 100 times is better than, or you're better at than something you've done 5 times, okay? So I hope you've taken something from this video. I know it's kinda all over the place, not as much as my other videos, but I hope you've learned something. Thank you all for watching, have a good day, and I will see you next time.